Poker is a gambling game. You have pursued a life of vice and dissipation, and you are no doubt expert in such pursuits, but no conclusions drawn from such an existence will apply to a life rightly lived.
Life is life, and cards will teach you what you need to know. You, madame, you speak of your life with your husband who awaits, and you fly to him in the certainty he'll love you as he did 3 years ago. Bon, 3 years. There was a flame. You do not know there is.
Among decent people, relations are eternal. Decent people stay true. To others, to themselves.
Life is change.
Presumptuous man. You say my daughter doesn't love me, that my husband no longer does.
If he ever did. No offense, madame. My point is that we can never know, not to the deepest level. And the word love, well, it can have different meanings, no?
Hold
on there,
mister.
I know what love means.
Your husband was a lecturer. We was a educator. Would you say he was a man of charisma?
He was. He is.
Oh, love would mean something quite different to such a person who commands the love of the crowd than it would to a person who can only coax love through subservience.
I did not coax love from Dr. Betjeman. I am not a wheedler. My husband's love was freely given and endures.
His love was different from yours, it's all I say. Now, the person widely admired, he accepts love as a tribute, and he confers his own love as an honor for coming from him. It must have great wealth. But you, madame, you would not receive this gift splendidly as one who has no need, but you would grasp at it as a beggar.
Ain't no call for that.
How dare you!
You ask the great man, the admired man, he might well accept other love simply as is due from some of those who admire him. And why not? If the admirer is comely, it is a love of a different kind, of course, than the domestique. But in France, we say
l'amour... You! No, 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 no,